Welcome to Lecture Loops. So today we are going to learn about these two control statements. These are nested if else and else if chain or else if ladder. So in my previous video, I have already covered the topics of simple if and if else statement. And in the description, you will get the link of the playlist. Okay. And I will also tell you what the easiest method. The easiest method is that you can subscribe to my channel and then you will each time my new video comes, you will get a notification. Okay. So without wasting time, let's start with nested if else statement. So basically what is nested if else statement? Suppose you have one if statement like this. Okay. And these are the curly braces and then there is else statement for this particular if. Okay, so you know that you can write any statements inside this if, and also you can write any statements inside this else statement. So why not if else? If else is also a kind of a statement, so we can also write another if inside this. Okay, so suppose this is condition one and this is condition two, so like this. And else block like this, and in the same way and the else statement, else part. Okay, so you can write if else statement inside if, or you can write if else statement inside else, or you can write if else statement inside both if and as well as inside else. So when we write if and if else statement inside one if or one else statement, then it is called nesting, because it is one inside another. So that's why the term nesting is used for such type of statements. So this is all about the syntax, and now we'll see the working of this particular nested if else statement. So what will happen if in a program there are some statements that are executing and suddenly this if comes? Okay, so first of all, the program will check this condition one, and then there are two possibilities: either the condition will be true or the condition will be false. Suppose the condition is true, then we will come inside this particular block and this else block will be completely ignored. Okay, the control will never go inside this else statement if this condition one is true. All right, now we come inside this statement block, then we encounter one more condition. Okay, then this another condition two will also be evaluated. Again, there are two possibilities: either the condition will be true or the condition will be false. If condition is true, then this particular block will be executed. And if the condition is false, then this particular block will be executed. Okay. In both the cases, either this will be executed or this will be executed, never both. Okay. So we can, summarize it like this. Like if condition one is true, okay, and condition two is also true, then we are going to execute. Suppose we name it as block one, block two, block three, and block four. So suppose if condition 1 is true as well as condition 2 is true, then block 1 will be executed. If condition 1 is true but condition 2 is false, then block 2 will be executed. Got it? Now suppose we evaluated this condition. So suppose we evaluate this condition and it comes out to be false. In that situation, we are going to ignore this particular portion, and the control will directly be transferred inside this else block. Inside else block, there is one more condition, condition 3. So condition 3 will be evaluated. Again, there are two possibilities: either the condition will be true or it will be false. So suppose if condition is true, then block 3 will be executed. If condition is false, then block 4 will be executed. Again, we can summarize it like this. Suppose condition 1 is false and condition 3 is true, then block 3 will be executed. If condition 1 is false while condition 3 is also false, then block 4 will be executed. So this is the basic nested if else statement. Now let's implement it. So suppose here I'm asking marks from user, and suppose passing marks are 40. Okay, so we'll write like this: if marks are greater than 40, then we'll do something, and else we are going to write, if marks are less than 40, then we will write you are fail. Okay, so this is one message. Now suppose if marks are greater than equal to 40, then we can check one more condition, that if marks are greater than equal to 60, okay, then we can print cout grade A, okay, and else we can write grade B. Yes, so what will happen, the user will enter the marks, okay, in this variable marks, and if marks are greater than equal to 40, then we will check another condition, that if marks are greater than equal to 60 or not. If marks are greater than equal to 60, then we will print grade A, and if marks are less than 60 but greater than equal to 40, then we will print grade B. But if marks are less than 40, then we will print you are failed. Okay, so simply here we have done this if else statement. Okay, nested if else statement. So let's save this and run it. So enter your marks. So let's say we enter marks 56. Okay, so it must print grade B. Perfect. Then let's say we print marks 70, grade A, perfect. And now suppose we enter the marks as 23, then you are failed. Okay, so in this way we can perform nested if-else statements. Now we jump to this else if letter or else if chain. Now else if letter or else if chain, basically it is used for, you know, multi-way decision making, or to check, we can say to check multiple conditions. If there are multiple conditions, then we can use else if chain or else if letter. How we are going to use it? First of all, if, then this condition one, okay, and then the associated block of statements, then we will write else if, okay, and then again condition two, okay, and then block two like this. Then again, if there is one more condition, then you can write like this B3, and at the end you can use this else block. And this is the last block. This is the default block. If all the conditions are false, then this default block is going to be executed. Okay. So how this works? This is the syntax of this else if chain or else if letter. So first of all, the condition one will be evaluated. If there are two possibilities, true or false. If this condition one is true, block one will be executed and rest of the construct will be ignored, okay, or will be skipped. Suppose the condition is false, in such situation we are going to check the condition two. Again, there are two possibilities, true or false. If condition 2 is true, then block 2 will be executed and rest of the statements or rest of the block will be ignored. Okay. Now, if condition 2 is false, then it is going to check the condition 3. So, we can say it like this, that in else if chain or else if ladder, each condition from top to bottom, each and every condition is tested from top to bottom one by one, and as soon as the condition is found true, the block associated with that particular condition is going to be executed and rest of the statements are going to be skipped. Okay, will be skipped. Understood? So now we are going to make a program using else if statement. So let's say this time I'm entering two numbers, enter two numbers, okay, and then we are going to compare these two numbers whether they are equal or greater or less than. Okay, so we'll write n1 and in the same we are going to take n2. So we will, I'm going to delete this and then yes, if n1 is equal to n2, then we can say both are equal. Otherwise, we will check else if n1 is greater than n2, then we will print n1 is greater than n2. Okay, and only one condition is remaining, so we will just write else if both, you know, previous conditions are false, then only one condition is remaining, that is n2 will be, n2 would be, n2 is greater than n1. Okay, so in this way we can use else if statement. All set. Let's run this. Enter two numbers. Suppose I enter 34 and 56. So n2 is greater than n1. Again, suppose I enter 22 and 22. Both are equal. In this way, we can check the equality of two numbers. Okay. So this is all about else if. If you understood all these programs and concepts, then please press the like button and also subscribe to my channel and share this video with your friends also. Thank you very much.